This video clip explains how to interact with point cloud objects in 2D viewpoints, such as a floor plan view of the design project. When an imported point cloud is placed as a GDL object, it can be selected just as any other GDL object can. In the floor plan viewpoint, the point cloud object has a single hotspot. This hotspot is automatically generated at the center point of its 2D bounding box. However, to select the point cloud object, you don't have to find and click this hotspot. This is because every point within the point cloud object is sensed by ArchiCAD's cursor and with other methods of selection. Thus, in the floor plan viewpoint, you can select a point cloud object by clicking on any of its points. Also, if you are selecting elements with the help of the marquee, the hotspot at the middle of the point cloud object does not have to fall inside the marquee area. If at least one point of the point cloud object falls inside the marquee area, it will be selected. When you have two or more point clouds overlapping in the floor plan viewpoint, the display order defines which one will be selected. If you click on the overlapping portions of the two point clouds, the one overlapping the other will be selected. One additional thing to know about point clouds and 2D viewpoints is that point clouds are not displayed in detail viewpoints and worksheet viewpoints generated from a viewpoint containing point cloud objects. So, if you have a point cloud object in your floor plan viewpoint, and you draw, for example, a detail marker boundary that encloses part or all of your point cloud object, the point cloud object will not be displayed in the generated detail viewpoint. You may, however, place a point cloud object in a detail or worksheet viewpoint, and in that way, its 2D will be displayed.